Hello, this is Chaplain Bob, Light of the World Ministries. Lesbian mayor in Houston, by the name of Annise Parker, an openly lesbian mayor for the largest city in Texas called Houston, has decided that all Christian churches in the city shall submit any and all sermons in advance concerning homosexuality, sodomy, transgender, anything that they consider to be derogatory towards homosexuality or lesbianism. You see, Houston passed a anti-discrimination ordinance, and we wouldn't want those Bible believing people to, say nasty things about those sodomites or homosexuals, you know. And so if you want to solve that problem, all you got to do is get yourself an NIV Bible and or a Queen James Bible, not King James, but Queen James, and all those terrible things that God said about sodomy have been pre-deleted. So, hey, you don't even have to worry about it, you know. But so much for freedom of speech in the First Amendment. You see, sodomites, homosexuals, lesbians, whatever, don't you remember they are always running around saying, all we want is tolerance. We just want tolerance. But when they get into power, like this lesbian mayor, they show nothing but, of course, intolerance, because you know what? They know what the Bible says, even better than the churchgoers. They know that it says that sodomites should be put to death. They know that. Your average churchgoer doesn't. And even if they did know that, their pastors will explain it away and say, well, you know, that was a different dispensation. That was only for the Jews. That was only for the Jews. That doesn't apply to us. We're New Testament Christians. That doesn't apply to us. Well, you know what? I'm glad this Houston lesbian mayor came out of the closet. And I hope she does put some of these pastors in jail. Oh, and by the way, she's threatened them that if they don't comply and submit their sermons in advance, she's going to hold them in contempt of court. Okay? She's going to get probably a sodomite judge or a lesbian judge and decide that, you know, you're not complying with this anti-discrimination ordinance, and we're going to put you in jail until you comply. You know, actually, I'm hoping this happens. You know why? Because now the church is starting to reap what she has sown. The Bible says that judgment begins at the house of God. And all these churches said, explained away where, you know, what to do with homosexuals and sodomites, but the church explained it away and they let them become school teachers. You know, they let them become Boy Scout leaders. And the chickens are coming home to roost. Matter of fact, it won't be long before these people start demanding and having Christians put to death, at least the ones that hold to the true Word of God. But don't worry, your pastor, if he's a member of a big mega church, he'll just switch to the NIV Bible or the Queen James Bible, where all the verses about sodomites being put to death have been deleted, and then it won't become an issue. Hey, and oh, by the way, witches are oftentimes into lesbianism. So, you know, what can I tell you? All right, well, I thought I'd give you this thing. And oh, by the way, don't expect to hear about this on your nightly news, because they're not going to tell you this is happening. So, All right, well, this is Chaplain Bob, Light of the World Ministries, John 8:12. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Actually, people, I'm sick of this lukewarm garbage going on in these 501c3 corporations that have the name church in it. Yeah, your church, it's a corporation, a tax-exempt corporation. And if you don't comply with the IRS's tax-exempt rules, like, going against public policy, you know, like teaching that sodomites should be put to death, like the Bible says, you'll lose your tax. They'll lose their tax exemption. And then the IRS will hit them with back taxes, and if they don't pay, they'll throw the pastor in jail for tax evasion, like they did Kent Hovind. And that's why your pastors explain away clear Bible verses that tell you what to do with sodomites. And it's not to let them become Boy Scout Cub Masters, and it's not to become elementary, middle, and high school teachers. Okay? So, judgment begins at the house of God, people. Yeah. The church is going to reap what she's sown for the last 50 some odd years. So, okay. This is Chaplain Bob signing off. In Jesus' name, Jesus' precious name, amen.